Okay. Hi. A lot has happened. I did not plan this video. I haven't talked to a camera in a while. Usually I do uploads every week, but I haven't been because, as I mentioned in my last video, I went on a trip. I spent 18 days traveling around Taiwan solo, and I've learned and gained so much along the way. I can't talk about everything in one video because it's gonna be a very long video. So instead, I just want to give kind of like a pep talk to people, because one thing that people kept telling me was that, wow, you're so brave to be doing this on your own. And it's really funny, like before doing this trip, I would never consider myself a brave person. I'm not brave. I don't like taking risks per se. I think over time I've gotten better at being more open to possibilities. I'm open to new chances, but I am not one to enjoy change or to take big risks, like stepping into the unknown. The last video's title was literally taking steps forward, something like that. That's what I do. I like putting one foot in front of the other and planning ahead. But this time, I just took this huge leap outside of my comfort zone, right? And I find myself still a little bit reserved in the beginning when I meet new people. I think I force myself to initiate. I keep doing that throughout the trip. I force myself to say yes, or I would talk to myself first, like, okay, Angel, there's this person next to you, talk to them. Like, I keep telling myself to do things that I usually would just not do. I'm not comfortable talking to strangers, but I kept doing it throughout the trip, and I'm really glad I did, because I met some amazing people along the way. People, places, just so many things that were unplanned. Just really, really pleasant surprises. A lot of them throughout the trip. And I keep sighing because it's like every moment, every day was so precious, and I enjoyed almost every second of it, I want to say. Even if it wasn't with other people, or even when I wasn't doing anything, like when I'm just on the train or whatever, when I'm alone, I still journaled a lot. So this one is like my beloved treasure. I kept all kinds of memories in here, stamps and tickets, and I wrote whenever I was alone, mostly when I was alone, sometimes when I'm with other people, because I just really like documenting stuff in the moment, because then when I read back, I'm like, oh, I wrote this at this place, at this time, maybe even next to someone, and I just can imagine myself back there in that moment. Okay, so I said this was gonna be a pep talk to people. I think I was really scared going into it. Like the first day or two, I was very like hesitant to do things. I felt really sad on day, I think it was day two or three, when I felt like I didn't really talk to anyone, because for some reason I felt the need to talk to people, because I wanted the trip to be all about storytelling and really getting to know Taiwan and people, just stories anywhere that I go. But then I sometimes felt like I wasn't doing enough. Then I started to realize, like, I shouldn't have to force anything, right? This trip isn't about showing people that I've gained something. It's to show myself that I can be comfortable being alone, or I can be comfortable just being really present, you know? So even though, yes, I have goals, I have things that I want to do with the content that I have created or that I have recorded throughout the journey. And I wrote so much throughout the journey. Like, I keep typing in my notes every day, all these just little scribbles of journals. And sometimes I only write. So what I had to do was I had to type what I write out into my notes, and then I always type too much. So when I post them on Instagram, I have to shorten them. And then in the future, I am definitely going to post all these long stories, histories, and conversations onto a blog or a website. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna do that because it's worth it. It's worth the time and effort. I know I'm going to look back onto it and smile to myself, and hopefully those people will too. If you have met me through this trip, hi. I really just encourage you, whoever is watching, if there's something you want to do, just do it. Because even though it might seem scary, you'll make yourself so proud when you finish it. I'm very proud of myself. Also, just really happy that I did this. This trip has reminded me why Taiwan is just awesome. Taiwan is awesome. It really is. Sorry, I have a lot going on personally. There's still a lot of uncertainty with things. So I don't know how long I'm gonna be where. But that's life, I guess. You never know. You just never know. And maybe that's okay. I'm grateful that I got to do this trip. I'm grateful that I am healthy and happy. I am shook that it is close to the end of November. December is coming. Crazy. In Chinese, there's this saying, 饮水思源, which means drinking water and thinking about its origin. Like, always giving thanks to the roots. So giving thanks to where you're from, who's been there since the beginning, and just everything that has brought you to where you are today, made you who you are today. Even though life can be so complicated and tough, we are constantly growing, and you should be constantly growing and pushing yourself to be better, to do more. I'm repeating myself a lot, maybe, but I really think it is so important. And after this trip, I don't know if I've said the same things before this trip, but now that I'm done with this trip, I want to be more confident. That was one of the advice that I got from a girl that I met along the trip. She told me to be more confident. And yeah, moving forward, I want to show that, not just in front of my camera in these videos, but when I meet someone in real life, I want to show this part of me because I am proud of myself now. I know that I can do anything when I put my heart into something that I'm passionate about. And I am passionate about a lot of things that I do. Whew. Can't believe the trip went by so fast, and I miss it, kind of. The waking up in the morning not knowing what will happen today is really exciting. Every day was quite a surprise. It's nice being home too, to be with family and friends again and get back to reality, because I do still have school and stuff. I've talked for 12 minutes now. I'm not sure how long this video will be after I edit it, but thank you for listening to me. I hope wherever you are happy and safe and doing something, you know? Work on that thing that you want to do. Do you. Yeah. Believe in yourself. You got to. May we all live and love as much as we can every day. Oh, and I will definitely be singing or doing stuff more now that I'm back. I think.